Mr. Tulsian, good afternoon, sir. Let me start with the numbers at hand first up. Let's take a look at Nestle and whether you at all would be, you know, worried because of this India sales number. It's 8% because they had to pass on the GST cuts. At current valuations, how would you look at a stock like Nestle?
See, passing on GST cut is a set rule of the law. Mm. I don't think that that should definitely get factored in. And even if I exclude the excise adjustment, you know, because I have not been able to calculate it. Because in the previous quarter of the previous year, the excise burden was only at 83 crore on a top line of domestic sales of about 2200 crore. So I don't know whether the domestic sales can be taken from 8% to 14% after making this adjustment. And even if it is presumed to be at 14%, you know, excluding this excise duty, because this gives me 3.75% effect of the excise duty, you know, even if I make this adjustment to make the comparable figures of the previous quarter, that is of June 2017 vis-a-vis June 2018 of this one, I don't know whether the volume growth will be seen at 14% or not. So taking these into account, I think the numbers are seen little disappointing, as I said, that 8% and 14%. Because I have my reservations on 14%. So, and apart from that, the valuations of the, you know, which I have been saying for last couple of weeks, actually this applies for all the richly valued stocks, that once you see the results coming in, you find them to be quite expensive. Even if I take the 175 rupees as EPS, the stock is ruling at a P multiple of 55, 57, which are definitely seen to be quite compelling, even if I compare with the other FMCG stocks. Not necessarily maybe in the staple space. So going forward, things are, even if the stock, I don't think, I'm not saying that the stocks will collapse, but I don't think that you have upside potentials going forward on these stocks, unless until all these FMCG stocks are ruling at a P multiple of maybe about anywhere between 45 to 50 or maybe 45 to 47 on the current year earnings.